shit go crazy.
What's going on, my good folks? It's your man, your guy, your boy. 1127 Kicks. I hope everybody out there is having a great day, an amazing day, and overall blessed day. Say, man, if you're new to the channel, do your boy a huge favor. Hit that like button. Go ahead and subscribe to the page. And if you're already with the movement, bro, I greatly appreciate you, man. Hit that like button, share this video, and let's go ahead and keep this page growing. So, man, we're a few days outside of this release date. And the shoe that we're going to be talking about today is the Air Jordan 12 Reverse Flu Games. Now, I believe a week ago, I did do the copper drop video on this shoe, but since it's the 21st and the shoe is coming out on the 27th, y'all already know your boy has to hit y'all with the how to cop video. So if you're new to the page, when we do the how to cop videos, man, we're going to talk about resale, where you can find the shoe, do I think the shoe is going to sell out, and things of that nature right there, man. I'm going to try to set you up the best way that I possibly can, man, so you can give yourself the best chance to actually cop the shoe if you want this shoe. So just getting into the shoe real quick, as you can see, man, pretty much it's the exact reverse of the Air Jordan 12 Flu Games. You reverse that black with the red, and then you reverse the red with the black, and that's pretty much what you have right there with this shoe. Now, one thing that I really do like the upper material of this shoe. It looks like a suede, or you know, a rough nubuck suede or something like that, but it looks really, really nice. I feel like the quality on this shoe will be A1. That's just in my personal opinion right there, man. I feel like this is a very solid pickup to actually have in your collection, especially if you don't have flu games. I'm not too big on the whole reverse Air Jordan thing, but in this case, man, I really feel like Jordan Brand and Nike actually got this one right. Now, let's go ahead and talk about this resale, bro, because I know that's pretty much what everybody cares about. That's what everybody's looking for, man. So just looking at it, man, like a size on StockX, like a size 7, a 7.5, they're looking, you know what I'm saying, it looks pretty decent, it's not too bad. Then after that, it pretty much balances out to, like, you know, 270, 260 or something like that, man. A size 12.5, you already know how I feel about that. That is definitely a unicorn size, so I really feel like that you can't miss when it comes to that. But overall, man, with this shoe right here, I will honestly say if you do get this shoe, this is definitely a shoe that I feel like that you're going to have to hold. You feel what I'm saying? And just wait for the stock to go up, honestly, with this shoe. But like I said before, as you can see on StockX, man, nothing too crazy, bro. You see a size 7, 7.5. If you cop that 12.5, then I feel like that you could definitely maximize your profit. But after that, man, pretty much everything pretty much balances out, man. So like I said before, if you don't get that 7, that 7.5, or that 12.5, man, definitely hold for a little bit, and I think you'll be good to go. And when you look at GOAT, it's pretty much the same exact thing, man. So GOAT is a little higher, man. Like that 7, 7.5 looks good, and then you see like 280, or you know, just basically that's what it's balancing out to, man. So honestly, if you want to, I would definitely say try to sell on GOAT. The prices on GOAT is a little bit higher, man. And like I said, you got people like me who actually rock with GOAT a little more than StockX, man. Like if y'all haven't seen my videos, y'all already know how I feel about StockX and everything like that. It'll be a desperation move if I have to go back to StockX and get a shoe. But other than that, man, you know, some people will actually pay that extra money to get a shoe off of GOAT rather than StockX, man. So definitely, you know, look at, you know, the playing field as far as resale goes with either, you know what I'm saying, site with the shoes, man. Now, as far as where you can go ahead and cop this shoe, I will definitely have a store list up, man, and I will have it up there for a pretty hot minute so you guys can actually just see everywhere that this shoe is going to be dropping. And this is actually a very solid list because I definitely went ahead and checked if they was missing anything, and I think the only one they was missing is Chic. Other than that, and I believe Hibbett Sports, other than that, or City Gear, but other than that, man, it's a pretty solid list. This is where these shoes will be released, man. It's being released in a lot of places. Once again, I really already felt like that this shoe was going to be a huge GR type of shoe, man. I really don't feel like that this shoe is going to be too hard to cop, but at the same time, we already know how the year 2020 has been, especially with COVID and stuff like that. So I would definitely sit there and say, don't sleep on the shoe. Don't sleep on the shoe. I don't think it's gonna be one of those shoes that you're like, I just wait a little bit past release to see if I can get them. Don't do that, bro. Do not do that. I definitely say, man, if you have an opportunity to get the shoe and you want the shoe, don't toy around with it, man. Just go ahead and cop the shoe, because the way things been going in 2020 with these shoes, everything sells out pretty fast, man. So, hey, don't sell yourself short when it comes to this right here. Do not sell yourself short when it comes to that, man, because I'm telling you, you would definitely be surprised. Now, do I think the shoe is going to sell out? Pretty much, yeah, I feel like it's going to sell out, man. I don't think it's going to be an instant sellout, but it will sell out the day of release, man. I don't think anything less of that. I don't think that you'll have extra sizes or whatever just sitting around, man. But one thing that I can say is, I know the Air Jordan 13 Hyper Royals that just recently dropped, they sold out really quick. Then Nike actually put out a second batch of those. So I'm thinking, man, it might be a chance that Nike actually do the same thing with the shoes. I feel like they might go ahead and sell out, and then they might throw, you know, pretty much a restock on up in there, man, because I really do feel like that they have a boatload pair of these shoes right here, bro. So honestly, I really, really wouldn't trip too hard if it sells out, because I do, you know, expect to see, you know, a few restocks, you know, coming with the shoe, especially with it being the end of the year. Nike, they always do that, you know, Foot Locker, Foot Action sites and stuff like that. They always doing restocks and everything. Now, I believe Finish Line, they already did their app reservation. So if you already copped on that, man, congratulations with that, bro. You know, dope salute to you. Make sure you go ahead and put that in the comment section below. And then on top of that, you know, you already know Foot Locker, Foot Action, Champs, you know, they're already doing their reservations for the shoe right here, man. So make sure y'all go ahead and tap in with that, man. Get your reservations in there. Put your head start points in there. And just, you know, give yourself the best chance that you possibly can to actually get in this shoe right here, man. And hopefully none of the Flex apps, you know, reservation things crash like it did with the Jubilees and everything like that, man. Because, I mean, yeah, that happened with the Jubilees. Yeah, I don't even want to speak on that. But overall, man, there you have it with this shoe. I hope this video is very informational for y'all, man. Let me know how y'all feel about this shoe in the comment section below. Is this shoe a cop or is this shoe a drop, man? Is this shoe for the toe or, you know, is this strictly for the resale? Do you think the resale will actually be up there with this shoe? Once again, man, I really feel like that other than the 7 and the 7.5 and the 12.5, this is strictly a shoe for the toe. And if you do get multiple pairs, man, hold on to it. The value of the shoe will definitely increase over time, man. You just honestly have to be patient. But I don't see this being an instant, you know, $400, $500 shoe. I can honestly see this shoe probably maxing out at $300, $325 or something like that. Maybe a little higher, but it's gonna take some time, man. So make sure you just pay attention to that. Don't get discouraged when you see that resale price. You know, if you got multiple pairs, just stay calm, you know what I'm saying, and go ahead and just be patient, and it'll go up for sure, man. But I just want to say I love y'all, I appreciate y'all, thank y'all, man. Justice for George Floyd, as always, and y'all already know how we finna end the video off. If you search for good, you shall find favor. If you search for evil, you shall find you. Proverbs 11:27, and we walk in faith and not by sight, for what is seen is temporary, what is unseen is forever. I live by that, I stand by that. And it's your boy 1127 Kicks. And always remember, bless your people, son.
Who done hit me up and told me shit on these niggas? 30 niggas out here came at you, going, showing the difference. Keep on dropping all of that shit that made you for wanna listen. You know these niggas ain't fucking telling, get out of here.